knew I didn't want to be a housewife like my mother and sisters. I've always known that I've wanted more out of life. I was 15, sitting in a coffee shop when a friend came by and said, "Hurry up, I've got a cab waiter, and you can make $100 in 20 minutes. He went to a penthouse. The guy up there, he was quite well known. He wanted to watch two women do it, and then he wanted to have sex with me. It was barely sex. He was basically finished by the time he started. It was a tremendous kick. There I was, doing nothing, feeling nothing, and in 20 minutes, I was walking out of there with $100 in my pocket. Just out of curiosity, how many of you have made $100 in 20 minutes of work? I was still in high school.
I think of myself as an upper-class working girl. The press calls me a socialite, which is just another word for a well-dressed fundraiser. I began a few years ago. I gave a party in Washington for Afghan refugee children. It wasn't for the country, although I'm sure that would have been fun too. But fundraising is work. It's hard to separate people from their money.
It was a marketplace transaction. Somehow I managed to absorb that while I was still quite young. I was a precocious child. Actually, I was sort of lonely. I didn't see myself as being attractive, and I didn't look like a Calvin Klein ad. But I was bright, and I didn't have to play by the rules. So, the guys, they were kind of scared of me. They didn't want to get involved emotionally, but, you know, they still wanted to. And for a while, I was willing to accept that, because it was feeling intimacy. It was feeling warm. It was feeling.
One day, I was riding around New York City in a limousine during a hotel strike, and there was nowhere to go. And I thought to myself, now I know what it feels like to be a bad lead. You can't just pick up every homeless person and bring them home with you. But if you can help by saying something entertaining, you bring a light into their eyes. Sharing is caring. Maybe that's what socialite means.
You become your job. I've become a hustler. Even when I'm not hustling, I'm still a hustler. What you do is what you are. I don't think it's terribly different from somebody who works 20 hours a week on an assembly line, comes home, cut off, numb. People aren't meant to switch on and off.